Bonjour! Hi! Welcome to another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, and today I want to show you how to create a CI/CD, Continuous Integration, Continuous Deployment, using Azure DevOps to deploy a static website. Si vous préférez, j'ai une version en français de cette vidéo. Cliquez juste ici, en haut à droite. What I want to do today is to deploy a generated static website using Azure DevOps pipeline. I don't want to build or generate the code on my machine. I want the build server to generate it for me. And then I want to use the Azure release pipeline to deploy it in the blob storage, not in a web app, but in a blob storage. It's very efficient and it's very low cost. So this video will be in three phases. The first one, the current one, is the context and to structure our folder, our repository. The second step will be to create our build pipeline. And finally, the last one, the third, will be to create our release pipeline, so our website get deployed in our blob storage. The generated static website are really making their return. We call that Jamstack for JavaScript API and markups. You can find many different generators online. The one I will be using today is WEM. I picked that one just because it was done in .NET and I was more comfortable, but you will find many others generator online. For example, you could find Jekyll, very efficient, Exo, done in JavaScript, or one that is very popular these days, Hugo, done in Go. All those websites are really great and they give you many themes so you could be building a website in no time. For example, the blog that I will be deploying today is that one. So I have a nice UI and tags and I have my post with images. It's really nice. And if we look at the code, you will see not that much. And talking about the code, let's have a look. So here I am in Visual Studio Code and most of the time, how it works for a generated website, you will have a source folder. So in my case, that folder is input. In there, you will find your images and your posts. And then you will have a output folder where all the generated content will be sitting. You don't want that generated content in your Git repository. That's only noise. So what you need to do is go in your git ignore file and put all the folder and the file you don't want to keep track. It may look simple, but it will save you a lot of space. All the code used in this sample will be available on my GitHub. Don't hesitate to go there and clone it.